this edition of Backstage Pass, we'll meet Orquesta Ritmo.
Salsa originated in Cuba.
You gotta play with your heart, not your head. Yep.
This music's all about the dancers. We don't have people up dancing, then we're doing something wrong.
I've been in the group a little over 2.5 years now. It's just the most fun I've ever had.
This kind of music is what we feel. It's our life.
This is the greatest music in the world.
Orquesta Ritmo, coming up next on Backstage Pass.
We'll be right back. Say that salsa was born in New York, and I'm certainly positive the name was born in New York, but those rhythms come directly out of Cuba. That if you're going to be technical about it, it goes back to 1502, and the first African slaves were brought into into the Caribbean.
It comes from the combination of the African rhythms with Spanish melodies. And the combination of those two is what actually created, you know, what's now known as, you know, salsa or Latin music.
There's another influence that gets overlooked, though, and this is the influence of the American big bands during the 1940s, you know, pre-revolution in Cuba. Havana was the playground of the rich and famous, and you know, one of the first tunes, El Manicero, which was one of the first son montunos that was actually orchestrated for a big band with a big band sound. So the American big bands had a big influence.
Ritmo means a rhythm in Spanish. The group got started actually kind of as a little garage band many years ago. We wanted to have parties and keep our own thing going here with the Latin music. We wanted to keep our own identity as you know, musicians and as you know, other things as far as the Hispanic community was concerned.
We're all jazz musicians. There's very little dancing, but for this music, you know, if we don't have people up dancing, then we're doing something wrong. It just feels so good. You can't hold still.
You don't have to necessarily understand the language to understand what the song is about, because I think it's about the dance. It's about the movement. You know, you can feel that part of it musically.
I don't speak Spanish either. It's also like listening to opera. You kind of get outside the words and listen to that. The singing as a melody and as another instrument and not being, you're not hindered by the words.
It's tough not to dance to this music. I mean, you know, it just kind of gets into you and you just start moving to it, you know? But, you know, as far as the Latin words, you know, to the American audiences, what they don't know is we're talking about them. You know, we're making up things about the audience as we go along. You know. No, not really. But.
Ojos tienes debajo de esas dos cejas, debajo de esas dos cejas, qué bonitos ojos tienes. Ellos me quieren mirar, pero si tú no los dejas, pero si tú no los dejas, ni siquiera parpadear. Malagueña y salero. Besar tus labios quisiera, besar tus labios quisiera, malagueña salerosa, y decirte niña hermosa, eres linda y hechicera, eres linda y hechicera, como el cantor de una rosa, y decirte niña hermosa. Si por pobre me desprecias, yo te concedo razón. Yo te concedo razón si por pobre me desprecias. Yo no te ofrezco riquezas, te ofrezco mi corazón. Te ofrezco mi corazón a cambio de mi pobreza. Malagueña y salerosa. Debajo de esas dos cejas. enamoras a cualquiera.
Debajo de esa trocera.
Ay, mírame más, mírame así, con tu mirada hechicera.
Falta un buen ambiente.
it's a large group. There's 11 guys up there playing. I'm originally from Northwest Michigan, a little small town called Ludington. It's a beach town, a vacation town here in Michigan. And I started on Suzuki violin and took piano lessons as a real young child. And then my musical mentor was a guy named Larry Fay. I originally wanted to play saxophone, but then he turned me on to trombone. I played in the big band in a jazz sextet, played in the trombone choir, a brass quartet, did whatever I could to play music. And then I got a call to sub in this group when their regular trombone player was out. I've been in the group over 2.5 years now. It's just the most fun I've ever had. Russ McMartin plays lead in the band. He's a tremendously talented trumpet player. He has a degree in music education. He's been classically trained and also marched in the Drum Corps International Series over the summers and honed his chops that way. He also plays in big bands and has a brass quintet. Mike Saylors just joined the group recently. He just finished his master's at Michigan State. Mike's a great player and has had a lot of training and does a lot of different playing too. I mean, both on the classical side and the commercial side and the jazz side.
Played music through high school. New Flint, played bassoon, bass finally in rock and roll bands. When I got into jazz, I learned about, I guess Latin jazz would be the best term, more or less salsa. And then I lived in New York for 18 years. And this kind of music is on the radio 24/7. I moved back to Michigan and hooked up with Mike, and I've got a chance to play it to a much bigger extent here, and I still continue to study it and listen to it.
I started off on piano, and so a lot of my studying was just after school programs, private lessons, and then ensembles that were not associated with the school. I went to high school up in the Traverse City area, and did my last year of high school at Interlock in Arts Kit. And I got hooked on Latin music very early, and then I just started studying. I started studying with anybody I could, on congas, on timbales, which took me down to study in jazz studies down at Cincinnati, and I studied with some Latinos down there. And then I hooked up with these guys.
Tim actually studied out at Berkeley for a while, one of the music schools. Carmelo, coming from Puerto Rico, 90% of the time they do it just by feel. And, you know, that's kind of like what he does. Oscar and Paul are from the Grand Rapids area.
Paul is an outstanding jazz pianist. Just incredible ears. He got his degree from Aquinas College. Oscar spent quite a bit of time in New York City, and he's worked with a lot of Latin groups. Everything from the very folkloric, more Santeria-oriented Afro-Cuban music to, you know, hard-hitting, kind of brass-in-your-face salsa. So, you know, it's a real treat to have him also up front with Mike. Mm-hmm. Singing on a lot of the tunes. It really brings a great flavor to it.
It's amazing that the quality and the volume of the voice that comes from that little guy right there.
No existe un momento del día que pueda apartarme de ti. El mundo parece distinto cuando no estás junto a mí. Bella melodía donde no surjas tú ni yo quiero escucharla. Si no la escuchas tú es que te has convertido mi alma. Ya nada me conforta si no estás tú también. Más allá de tus labios, del sol y las estrellas, contigo en la distancia, amada mía, estoy. Donde no surjas tú, ni yo quiero escucharla, si no la escuchas tú, es que te has convertido. Si no estás tú también, más allá de tus labios, del sol y las estrellas, contigo en la distancia, amada mía.
Michael, yeah.
Thank you. Si no estás tú también.
I was born in Cuba, and I lived there until about the age of 10. There, I just progressed more to the you know, the Cuban style of salsa music. Well, at the time, it was called, it wasn't really called salsa back then. It was, you know, it was guaguancos and cha-chas and rumbas and mambos and that kind of thing. It just kind of takes over you. I came to the United States in the early 60s, and I happened to end up here in Lansing. I lived at St. Vincent's home for a couple of years. Never picked up a guitar then until I got into high school and started playing with some of the high school bands. Later on, I thought, man, you know, I was just missing something. It just didn't quite have the feel that you know, that the Latin music had. So we got together and started our own little Latin group here, which was about, I think it was a five-piece then, two guitars, bass, congas, and timbales. And from there, it just took off.
So was there any music in your house growing up?
Well, just a little bit. Yeah, there's a little bit. When I was very
young, I mean, 3, 4, 5 years old, and the band was always practicing in the basement. I would go down there and listen and check it out. And I used to love the music, so.
I remember when he was 5 years old, he'd wake up right around 4:30, 5 o'clock in the morning, all of a sudden you start hearing this plonk, clunk on the piano. I'm going, what is going on? It was him practicing. I mean, that's all he's ever wanted to do. That's all he's ever wanted to do. He wanted to play music. And I thought, well, hey, you know, why not? Let's go for it.
When I was about 14 or 15, I actually started playing gigs with this band. So I'd play, you know, the East Lansing Arts Festival. We'd do the things like that around here. And I was able to read music a little bit more proficiently at that point and so on. And I got a lot of experience playing with this band before I had really played with many others. So this music, although I don't have a formal training in it, it's just been around me my whole life. So very into it.
He does get more solos than anybody else.
That's
in
true,
band.
I noticed.
If you'd like to find out more about Mike later on, off camera, we can do this.
But it's really neat to see these two guys in a band because they're both such great musicians, and it's just neat for me. Sometimes we're playing on a gig, and Mike will be soloing, and Mike Sr. will be looking back, and it's like this connection happens between father and son. But it's just a really neat thing, and it's just a really great. There's some great moments.
I get giggly when we play together because it's just such an amazing thing, you know. I keep thinking of him when he was about this big and now, you know, and what he's doing now.
Déjame soñar. Ódiame por piedad, yo te lo pido. Ódiame sin medida ni clemencia. Odio quiero más que indiferencia, porque el rencor hiere menos que el olvido. Ódiame por piedad, yo te lo pido. Ódiame sin medida ni clemencia. Odio quiero más que indiferencia, porque el rencor hiere menos que el olvido. Si tú me odias, quedaré yo convencido de que me amaste, mujer, con insistencia. Pero ten presente, de acuerdo a la experiencia, que tan solo se odia lo querido. ¿Qué vale más? Yo humilde, tu orgullosa. ¿Qué vale más? Tu débil hermosura. Piensa que en el fondo de la fosa llevaremos la misma vestidura. Si tú me odias, quedaré yo convencido de que me amaste, mujer, con insistencia. Pero ten presente, de acuerdo a la experiencia, que tan solo se odia lo querido. Pero ten presente, de acuerdo a la experiencia, que tan solo se odia lo querido.
Niño.
Odio,
te lo pido, sin medida ni clemencia.
De acuerdo a la experiencia, tan solo se odia
Valencia. Thank you.
Fun.
Feel.
Family.
Fire.
Repica la conga, ponla a sonar. Excitement. Que su música si vive, mamita. La salsa vive. La salsa vive en mi corazón. La salsa vive. Music is my life. And it kind of goes with what this band kind of lives by. This kind of music is, you know, it's what we feel. It's our life.
You gotta play with your heart, not your head.
Yep, exactly.
Yeah.
Me quedé dormido escuchando salsa. Soñé con el cielo y que San Pedro me esperaba. Ya estaba andando una fiesta enorme. Estaba cantando Héctor Lavoe y Pire el Conde. Y sentí un repicar, tipa sensacional, y era Tito Puente. Y empezando a improvisar, Frankie Ruiz hizo notar y escuché este coro.
Al inmortal Pellín Rodríguez.
Pero aquello enloqueció cuando escena se subió Ismael Rivera. ¡Tempo, hey! Y Tito Rodríguez fue. Algo tenía que ver. Y junto con ellos yo canté. ¡Azúcar!
La salsa vive, llega hasta el cielo. Que Dios bendiga la tradición de nuestro pueblo.
Cuando desperté, lloraba de la alegría de saber que está donde yo merecía.
La salsa vive, llega hasta el cielo.
Llega hasta el cielo.
Que Dios bendiga la tradición de nuestro pueblo.
En el cielo se escucha un coro tan feliz. Héctor Lavoe, Pellín el Conde, y Maestrito y Frankie Ruiz.
La salsa vive,
la salsa vive. Chicos, son los caballos nada más.
santo y mortal.
Seco.
visit Backstage Pass online at wkar.org.